May as well, I am back. Teeny still hasn't moved yet. Teeny has never been that patient. Motherhood, even a stand-in one, has made the unthinkable happen. I think they are nearly done there. There's Teeny, she is finally on ground level. Teeny must be starving too, waiting all this time. But to my surprise, the baby seems alert too. But Teeny is very suspicious of anyone coming near to her. She just ran back to higher ground every time the feeders or monkeys Inc. tried to do so. The baby appears to be starving too. And the moment you want to do something, she backs away. More milk is wasted. But Teeny needs goodies, especially so if she is lactating for her brother. And finally, Tina has pitched up. She seems stronger than yesterday. But she is still not well enough to go back to care for her baby. Her gait seems strained to me. There is something wrong with her pelvis. Teeny should be still up there somewhere. I wonder when Tina will be 100% herself. Can her baby wait? Tina seems to be totally at ease for Teeny to care for her baby. That's Trina. The whole family is there, in fact. Trina's little boy is nursing all this time, and he appears to be content as well. A newborn has no chance at all to survive all the last few days without any fluid. Someone must have been providing it just that to keep it alive. And now my bet is on Teeny during the daytime. Her milk probably is just all watery, as she has never had any time to develop any breast tissue for the job. And there is also a distinct possibility that Tina may nurse her baby at night too. Her input at night may just provide enough calories to keep her baby alive. But how long can this arrangement sustain this baby?
Hello,
My arms are really tired. This lens is damn heavy. I'll see whether I can climb up to get some milk to the baby. Tina is definitely sore there. Another feeder is here now. No luck again, they just retreat higher and higher. And now Teeny has gone back into the forest. There are a lot of ifs in my reasoning. If one of the ifs is true, the baby will still have a chance to make it. Monkeys Inc. will return tomorrow to check on them, and me the day after. So glad it all began on a Thursday. We have the weekend to deal with it. It will be dark soon. I have just one sweet potato left with me. Some of our gang are still hanging around further down along the road. I think they might have missed the second meals on wheels. Lucy's boy really is one of the cutest boys born so far.
Yeah. There.
They are going back to foraging. Whose baby is this? It's Aggie's. She has popped too. Will these little babies have a baby uncle or aunt? Let's find out. You can tell how big Tina's baby is in comparison. I still can't tell. But I think it is a boy, as I saw something that suggests a sack between its legs earlier on. So it looks like another brother for Alex. Unfortunately, Millie trumps Aggie. Never mind, I'll be back the day after tomorrow.